this week on Perspective, anger on the streets of France, Macron's crisis of leadership. Week after week, since the end of November, les Gilets jaunes have marched in the streets of France. The yellow safety vests that French drivers are required to keep in their cars have taken on a new symbolism. In their tens of thousands, the Gilets jaunes are demanding a different kind of visibility. Demanding to be listened to by their government and their president, Emmanuel Macron. First, it was anger about a fuel tax increase, and the protests were peaceful enough. But that anger quickly flared into violence and a damaging assault on the revered landmarks of Paris. Days later, as he toured the Arc de Triomphe, a grim-faced President Macron got the message directly. Ordinary French citizens say they can't make ends meet, don't like Macron's plans for economic reform. A reform agenda that began rather ineptly with cuts to the country's wealth tax. Much of the violence has been blamed on so-called professional rioters by government authorities. Police have been accused of brutality. Nevertheless, the protests have continued. Macron has been forced to walk back his economic plans, including the fuel tax increase. The man who was once hailed as a political hero, a dynamic, progressive bastion against a rising tide of populism, now finds himself on a desperate quest to restore his political credibility. On the program this week, a look at Macron, his political crisis, and what it means for France and for Europe. We begin in the streets of Paris with freelance journalist Cindy Palm, who has been covering the protests. Here's her street view.
For yet another week, Paris is burning. Protesters hurl bottles and confront police at a main square, Place de la Bastille. But the protests usually start out calmly. Macron may have canceled the planned fuel tax hike that sparked the movement, but in the weeks since they started, they're still out there. Manzana Pradenas is a part-time school crossing guard who says she brings home 800 euros a month.
On n'arrive plus à s'habiller, on n'arrive plus à se nourrir. On a du mal à payer nos loyers. Enfin, c'est pour ça qu'on est là aussi, pour dire stop.
Je gagne 579 euros par mois. Alors j'ai des aides sociales, mais même avec les aides sociales, la vie est difficile. Je mange des pâtes quasiment tous les jours. Mais moi vraiment, je ne suis pas comme une députée qui se plaignait de manger des pâtes alors qu'elle était à 5000 euros par mois.
Businesses brace for the violence, with storefronts on major streets boarded up week after week. This restaurant, Le Percier, had its window smashed and has had to close every other week depending on the scale of the protests.
J'ai l'impression que dans ce pays, c'est vrai qu'ils disent qu'il faut pour casser pour se faire entendre. C'est ce qui est un peu dommage, parce qu'on ne le voit pas ailleurs. Il n'y a, qu'en France qu'on le voit. C'est-à-dire qu'on est dans une démocratie, on laisse la chance d'avoir, finalement, de pouvoir manifester. Et finalement, ce qui est dommage, c'est que dès qu'il y a une manifestation de toutes sortes, il faut forcément que ça dégénère.
Government officials have called the violence thuggish. And this week, the National Assembly approved a draft law that would give security officials the power to ban protesters who pose a threat to public safety.
These protests have sometimes turned violent. And for the first time since the beginning of the Yellow Vest movement, there's now another group who say they have had enough of the violence, and they're taking to the streets as well.
They wear red scarves to try to stand out as much as the yellow vests.
On n'est pas contre les gilets jaunes, mais on est contre la violence.
Vive la République!
Je n'ai pas voté pour lui. Mais tout cela m'écœure.
In response to protests, Macron started national town hall meetings called grand debates to try to address people's concerns.
Et donc ce grand débat doit nous permettre de se dire les choses en vérité sur tout ce qui fonctionne, dysfonctionne et que nous devons appréhender.
Il parle très bien, mais c'est un menteur. On n'y croit plus à lui. On ne le croit plus.
Security was tight at the anti-violence protest as organizers wanted to ensure their event was peaceful.
Marchons, marchons, gazons à pu.
In spite of ongoing political efforts, the protests continue week after week on the streets of Paris and elsewhere in the country. Cindy Pong for CPAC in Paris.